Now we are going to discuss why we actually should move towards a circular economy. This question has come up in the previous episodes various times, but it has never been answered at this global level. So that's what we are going to do in this clip. What problem actually will be solved by going towards a circular economy of metals? Well, a circular economy means, of course, use less resources, or at least take less resources out of the environment. Because we keep them in the economy for a longer time, we may need less new materials. And that might have two advantages, and we are going to look into those things separately. The first is the issue of scarcity. It's possible that we are running out of certain materials, and that the circular economy may help prevent that. And the other thing is environmental impacts. By keeping the materials in the economy for a longer time, it's possible that we have less environmental impacts. In the 1970s, when the report of the Club of Rome appeared, we had 20 years of zinc left. Now, in the 2010s, we also have 20 years of zinc left. We see that those prospects have nothing to do with how much zinc there is actually left in the Earth's crust. They depend on technology and on economics. It means that we have enough zinc left in mines that we know can be accessed profitably to last us another 20 years. And this number, of course, changes as technology progresses and also as new investigations are being made. So we are now able to access ores that we couldn't in the 1970s. We can now use much poorer ores than 50 years ago. All in all, the geologists agree on this matter. Geological scarcity will not occur anytime soon, not for any metal. So the circular economy, from this point of view, is really not needed. Then what about the crisis around metal supply in the past? We had the cobalt crisis in the 1970s, palladium in the 1990s, rare earth elements in the 2000s. Well, these supply problems were not really caused by geological scarcity, not because we didn't have any of those metals left, but the reason was geopolitics. The supply depends on only a few mines in the world, and if anything happens to those mines or to the country where the mines are, then it may be that the supply is disrupted. And of course, this geopolitics is important as well, but it does not mean that we run out of those metals. But it does point to one of the potential benefits of the circular economy. If you access the urban mines instead of the geological mines, you spread the supply, so the world is not dependent on a few mines only. Unlike geological mines, urban mines are available and accessible in each and every country. And this will reduce, indeed, the supply risk.